Let's welcome our first guest on the show. Today we have a hospital chain, Shalby, which is in focus today. Vikram Shah, Chairman and Managing Director at Shalby Hospitals, joining in now with an outlook for the business going ahead. Welcome to the show, Mr. Shah, Dr. Shah. Let's, if we talk about the mix of your business, just to get an update as we've closed out fiscal 18. Something that we've spoken about recently was, it's largely skewed towards orthopedics. It comes in at about 71% versus, other segments. That this is as far as your FY17 goes. What will be the picture when we talk about FY18?
Well, we are having orthopedic subspecialty as our main subspecialty, which everybody knows. But there are few changes happening very fast now. We have got a tie-up with one major institution for heart transplantation. As far as hepatobiliary and liver transplantation is concerned, we have worked out very good deal with one very large surgeon group where they will be starting at our all units very soon. Also, we have worked up with Dr. Purvesh Parikh, who is supposed to be the leading onco physician of the country, where he will be heading our cancer institute, Shalby Cancer Research Institute. So this institute will be taking care of entire onco services like cancer surgery, cancer medicine, as well as radio therapy at our all units, present and future. So these are all changes happening where from orthopedic subspecialty, we will be in a real sense multi-speciality. We had been multi-speciality, we had been doing a lot of cardiac work, a lot of neuromedicine and neurosurgery work. But this addition of cancer surgery as well as this liver surgery and heart transplant will add on as a multi-speciality in our case. Also, we have started ramping up our occupancy in our own new units as well as in our older units, where average occupancy was last year 400, 350. It has gone 100 plus, that is 400 to 450. So, our overall occupancy also has started coming up.
In fact, we'll talk about your occupancy in a minute, but just wanted to get an update on this recent MOU that your company has signed. This is with Sensoke International Hospital in Cambodia, and I understand that you'll be sending orthopedic specialists to the hospital. Give us a sense of what this MOU entails and what kind of contribution are you looking at from this?
Yeah. Well, we have a number of MOUs in Africa also, and we have a lot of long-term relations in East African countries, Ethiopia, also in Sudan. Similarly, we have started working on Southeast Asia, where most of the Southeast Asia for a medical tourism purpose is going to Singapore or Malaysia or Thailand, where we have started attracting these patient base to Ahmedabad and our other units in India, where they find it cheaper than even Singapore or Malaysia, and also better treatment for their patient. And it is a bilateral relationship where we work for them for skill enhancement of their paramedics. We run Shalby Academy and Shalby Hospitals, where in Shalby Academy we train paramedicals of various kind, and number of things we are going to give in skill enhancement. And on the other side, they will be sending their high-end patient to us, where we are able to treat them.
All right, and like you're describing, you have multiple tie-ups with hospitals overseas or universities. Are you looking at any significant contribution in terms of revenue from the overseas space? Any target you can share with us at the moment?
Sure. Well, let me tell you, as far as medical tourism is concerned, it has been developing in India since last 10-20 years, but it is still a tip of an iceberg. Large part of medical tourism is taken away by USA, Germany and India, actually, and Singapore. These are all developed places which are taking large part of medical tourism in value base. So, basically number of patient-wise, we might be treating good numbers, but value-based medical tourism is happening in the Western world and developed countries where we can reach in and get more number of patients. So, the medical tourism business itself has a very, very big opportunity to grow if things are done in the right way.
All right, fair enough. And you, the last time we spoke, you just signed this deal with Gleneagles. Any further clarity that you have in terms of the timeline of implementing that, and also, you know, what kind of contribution, particularly the Gleneagles tie-up, will bring you?
Well, we have a number of MOUs now being done, and we have started working on it. And because we have an orthopedic base, we have a number of patients with head injury and who are treated where they are willing to donate their organs so that number of other lives can be saved. So, you know, it is a kind of spot where we are able to help number of people who otherwise die.
All right, fair enough. And just very quickly before we let you go, overall FY18 performance, we're of course still waiting by for the numbers, but will this be a year where you will be exceeding the sort of performance that you saw in FY17?
Well, as far as the hospital business is concerned, it is always a consistent business. It is a very low beta business, and what we had been able to do over the last 30 years, we have grown more than 30% per annum in last 10-15 years. In EBITDA as well as in top line. Similar growth we want to expect for a coming time also. You know, for a given year, it may be 5% plus or minus, but overall, we are a better company in the given sector, and then the sector itself is growing 15 to 18%. Naturally, we should be able to do it at 20-25% minimum.